Good evening, Warband. I hope all of you have had a wonderful day. I myself had a weird day, rough, so I'm just going to chill out and try a game that I've been looking at over and over again called Wildermyth. Now, this isn't like the most fancy looking game, but it looked fun to me. So we're going to check it out. It's also got overwhelmingly positive reviews on Steam. And so I wanted to give it a shot. Check it out. What, Dr. Nappy? Let's restart this program really quick. It's being weird. I can hear click-clacks. You're super mad today. Your dream gave you a really good pun, and before I could yell at it, your alarm went off. What? Am I missing a pun right there? All right. Oh, wow. This has multiplayer. I didn't know this had multiplayer. I actually had no idea this had multiplayer. So this is a, from what I can gather, I think this is a turn-based RPG, but I'm not sure yet. So I hope to give it a good look. Age of Ulstrix, a three-chapter story that is geared towards new players, face off against impeccable Gorgon leader, Ulstrix. So a Gorgon. All right. We're going to go with Adventurer. We're not going to get too crazy with that. Interesting. So I guess there's mods for this game. Okay, so what's party select? Okay, randomize. Snarky leader, greedy poet, compassionate leader, aloof peacemaker, compassionate greed wagon. What? I don't know. Passionate lower, greedy poet, greedy leader. For some reason, I wonder if I can get a greedy leader. Hot-headed greed wagon. Okay. For some reason, I want a leader. It's not going to give me one, is it? After I said that. Okay, so, well, why am I doing this to myself? Can I, like, oh! Oh, man, there is so much going on here. I've officially gone too far, it feels like. This game is called Wildermyth. I do believe that's, yeah, up there in the top left there. And it's a, it's got overwhelmingly positive reviews, and I hear it's got great storytelling. I think I passed all the best ones, man. I don't know what any of this stuff does. I just want something that looks good. Sure, let's go with Cowardly Greed Wagon. Sure. Hot-headed poet and compassionate goofball. You know what? Let's just stick with these. And it's all procedurally generated, like everything, all the choices, everything. This book, in it, there's a room in it for another story. It's cold, I'm stuck here. I can make my death sound really ridiculous. Alright, then I should at least start it serious. Here in our yondering country, something in the woods is very strange. Haunted only by the dust in his new boots, a young man named Esteldo takes the seasonal road to the town of Tallowald. I bet it'd be less expensive if I went in asking for a dozen. Yeah, a dozen candles, I'll say, and then, just suddenly, remember, I only need two. No way would that old guy raise the price. If he does, I'll guilt him. Breeze is light that day. Birds are timid. In fact, the whole world is taking a breath, ready to leap in the sea. Oh yeah, I can't wait to get like to the combat because I like looked at the videos and I was intrigued. It's been out for a minute, and I keep looking at it, and I decided, you know what, that's fine. Let's just do it. I'm there already, huh? Here's the hard part, getting Maltara out of bed. She'll probably be sitting up, blanket wrapped, staring out the window, gnawing a mouthful of old biscuits and telling me to consider the... to reckon with the... that smoke? Fluttering flames roost among the far-off rooftops. Estello hurries towards town, thinking of Maltara, a young woman whom he's known since boyhood. Oh, okay, so there's choices. Here's the choices. And Macon wants me to brush my beard. I can do that while I'm looking at these choices. So, we can, if she dies without paying me back, plus rivalry. She must have tried to cook breakfast again, plus friendship. And I'm really running toward the fire for her, plus romance. Oh, thank you so much for that beard brush, by the way, Macon. Okay, so... what kind of run are we doing? I don't know. What kind of run are we doing? There is going to be three party members which we're going to have relations with. So, or, well, our character and then two other characters. Oh, Paragon or Renegade, good or bad? We'll go good first. I always, almost always go good first. Let's go with friendship. Maltara, are you all right? I'll get you out. Just make a little noise. Romance everyone? No. Not everyone. We'll figure that out here later. I don't know how, I actually don't know how, oh, neat. Okay. All right, tactical. Here we go. Neat looking game. Her house still standing, at least. Maltara, fire out here. You're not sleeping, are you? He doesn't know? Why is no one door... the door unlocks. Maltara shoves it open. Hey, do you not smell that? I smell the smoke. Get inside. You have a bow? Yeah, there's things in the streets. You didn't see any, like, monsters. I don't know. I've got one trapped behind... I don't know what that noise is. Behind the house. We'll burn in here. Could we try to fight it? Right, so here, I've got some tools around. You're stronger than I am. You can swing something pretty good. I bet we can at least drive it off. Well, I'd like to keep this creature at arm's length, so pitchfork. If it breaks stones, it'll break bones. Pickaxe. This is for cooking. Why'd I grab this? A frying pan. Oh, man. I don't know, man. If it breaks stones, it breaks bones? Come on. All right, let's grab the frying pan. It can be killed, right? Just be ready when I open the door. Okay. It's a roe. Hooves thrown sloppily around beneath it, runs staggering, bellowing its agony. How are you, Weegis? Stand adjacent to an ally to wall with them. Walling reduces incoming damage by one and does not stack. Okay, cool. Easy peasy. Oh, we get to choose an ability. You're doing some farming on D2, so are you online or offline? Okay, so Battle Dance. Melee attacks only cost a solo one action, which is passive. Stalwart, active as a swift action, Estello can enable-disable Stalwart, which grants plus 3 armor and warding, but reduces his speed by 1/2. Blood Rage, infuriated by wounds, Estello deals plus 1 damage for every 2 health he is missing. I'm gonna go with Battle Dance. Archery for Maltara. After a ranged attack against her or any adjacent allies, Maltara counterattacks with a ranged attack of her own. Through shot. Maltara fires a cleverly placed arrow that will pass through the first target and hit the next target in a line, dealing minus 1 damage to the second target. Okay, in piercing shots, Maltara's ranged attack have 1 pierce. I'm gonna start with archery. And we found a Sash of Courage. It adds plus 5 block. Let's go ahead and give it to Esteldo. Online, nice. What kind of suffering did that poor beast endure? At least it's done. The creature's death is quiet. It seems to slip from life in a few stunned, hazy blinks. They'll spend a piece of the day getting the flames under control. The damage isn't as bad as it could have been. Townsfolk emerge from hiding to fight fires and clear debris. Some full of curiosity, others visibly haunted by what they've seen. We should go. Nikhil is alone, unless you think, I'm not sure who's safer suddenly. Nikhil? He's at the ruined tower by now. I'm thirsty, and this place is in rough shape. Others can take care of it, but Nikhil'll be waiting for us. What happened today could be happening everywhere, couldn't it? Something about that tower is just stuck in my mind. It's like when you get apple skin in your teeth. That sucks. I can feel that analogy. It's unpleasant. Yeah? Anyways, I think we said we'd meet him. We should. The tower's in the hills. You've been there. Yeah, once, actually, looking at the tracks. They come and they go that direction. Stello and Matara follow the pounded path of monstrous feet, hoping for the best and dreading every other possibility. So, rivalry, friendship, romance. Just to be breathing, okay, so we can all yell at you and go home. Let him be alive and unhurt. Nikhil, you said you'd be fine. Don't make me call you a liar. Ooh. Let's go with a romance on that one. Sure. A wordless while passes between them, but the quiet only heightens their worry. You've always been a little fond of him, I thought, of Nikhil. You mean I have? Oh. Is that true? No one does make me laugh like he does. There's more to him than that, but anyway. And plus, it seems like no matter where he goes, we tend to have adventures. Let me move me over a little bit. That way y'all can see some choices that are being made. In order to find sites in the wilderness, heroes must scout the land, which takes time. Click on an unscouted tile to show the action section. I guess most people didn't like what they saw in this game. That's fine, though. That's whatever. Apparently, a lot of stuff can happen in this game. Like, you could have something bad happen and a limb get chopped off and it change your character's story and all kinds of different stuff. And yeah, there's debuffs and buffs depending on situations, from what I understand. Oh, wow. Okay, so we can have more than three heroes? The previous night, the tower where Nikhil has arranged to meet Esteldo and Malteria is a place he often used to escape as a boy. He knows its rooms and floors so well. He could survive being chased through them. Cough, cough? Coming from inside the building? And now I wait, I suppose. Dust gets deep as rain puddles in here. Alive is alive until that beast breaks through. What do you say, beast? Woof, snuff, furl. I don't know what's going on here. Even you must be bored. The tower has outlived generations. The emptiness is deep and fragrant. The odor of 10,000 rains that have soaked into stone. But as the old will tell you, precious things go overlooked in a ruin. What lodges amid the stone of failure is often the dream that drove it. That book, why have I never... Easy there. Guess you're wondering why I'm talking to myself, huh, Beast? I'm also wondering, Nikhil bends to pull it loose. The book heavier than its slender spine suggests. The Book of Wildermyth. Look at all this. The full strange stories, the folklore of folk long forgotten. Circles of the Ancients. It's wild nonsense how a woodcutter can read the rings inside old trees to find the exact moment a grove began calling itself a forest. Chant of the Soil. Lacks any satisfying action, it's told through the mind of a blind, deaf tea grower. His nose is so sharp, he learns the song of the scented earth, and so avoids slaying worms with his shovel. The Tallowald Girl, tells of a blight-skinned woman who drew things so fillingly that they began to come true, and she drew circles and circles in a book and eventually fell through. Nikhil reached the last word of the final tall tale. A few blank pages are left. This book. Something in him feels like it's coming loose, but he can't tell exactly what. There's room in it for another story. You're a poet and didn't even know it. It's cold. I'm stuck here. Alright, then I should at least start it serious. Here in our yondering country, Nikhil writes, words are ready, omens have formed in the fabric of everything, and he's beginning to recognize them now. Some are just misgivings. They crept through his body like the sourceless aches are one wakes with. Others are more substantial. Now they seem a lightning plain, a promise of thunder. For in the wild black woods where birds once belled, a hateful silence turns. Spooky. Pain lights Nikhil's head. Subsides. I made it to morning? He lowers his bleary eyes. His story lies before him in luminous script. Empty pages have sprouted behind it. Why do I feel powerful? Ooh, okay, choices. Okay, so he pulls the spoon from his pocket. He slides a branch from the rubble. It's sturdy and has palm-loving twist. Ooh. Should it be a spoon or a staff? What do we give him? We gave the other guy a frying pan. So what do we give this one? Yeah, a spoon or a staff? A spoon. That's what I thought you guys were going to choose, but I had to be sure. Open wide, beast. I'm getting out of here. Those cards. We got a rager. It charges without seeing. Misshapen tusks swinging wildly. Alright, so let's destroy everything with a spoon. Spoon is strong, oddly enough. Interesting. How odd. Boom. So I can infuse things with magic and then cause the, and then depending on the item, it does a different ability. That seems pretty strong, man. So he's our spellcaster, obviously, I guess. He has grown stronger. As a mystic, Mikil has acquired the knack of interfusing his spirit with earthly things, drawing on these bonds to enact formidable magic. Archis, Nikhil bonds with the earth and summons from seedling and sill a wondrous tree that pins surrounding enemies. Mythweaver, advance interfusions. It gets a passive of on statues plus one potency per interfused statue. Garb, 50% chance, mystic reflex damage while interfused. Books give a lore dump and textiles greater constrict. Interesting. We also got compulsion. Briefly interfuses with an enemy and forces it to move where he pleases. So if we had a fire, we could force it to like move into the fire. Looks new. What's the pitch? It's not necessarily a super old game. It has been out for a minute. It's one I've looked at it numerous times. It's overwhelmingly positive because apparently the amount of choices you can make in the storytelling is really good. We're just getting into it. I'm going to go with Mythweaver. Oh, we got a brooch. Oh, man. We're just going to have to give it to him. He's the only one who can wear it right now. Have I played the Yogg? No. Says Paragon Run? What? More monsters roam the ruined halls and rattled the rotting furniture. But Nikhil moves quietly, sensing his way in the dark. Daylight lands on his wrists. Cool wind soothes his tired eyes. Did I make it? I did, didn't I? He closes the tower door, gentle to make no noise. What's with this mystic's art and... or... that I did, right, tower? Where'd I get it from? Could it have just happened? Is it just one of those things? Things a man's born with that might blossom in his life when he needs them? People would be so mad at me, but fortune likes a smile, they say. Nikhil? It'll be useful if I figure it out, of course. Hopefully I'm not endangering anything. Nikhil, you're okay. You're okay. You look like it. Hey, Nikhil, something happened? Maltara. You're here and you're safe. Good. Oh, sorry. And you too, Estella. Estella and I only barely made it. Yeah, see that smoke on the horizon? That's from the town. Yeah, that's Talawald. It burned? Daru! There's more monsters in the tower. Things are different than they were. Hmm. Yeah, well, I don't know if you've ever seen something quite like this. A monster? Sure we have. We slay monsters. The look. Like, excuse me. Well, I'm a wizard. Yeah, but I can't say I have Ouija's. I've discovered new sites, so this is where the choices happen?